Nail clippings were not taken because instructions were not given. Now, nail clippings are important, viewers, because they can bring out details like whether the individual had consumed toxic substances or not. These are very important evidences that need to be collected and presented and analyzed. Not done. It wasn't done. So is it fair to ask today, viewers, that the Mumbai police is part of a cover-up? That's the question. And I want to bring in, first of all, Mukul Rohatgi, who is part of the defense team, really representing the interests of the Sushant Singh Rajput family. Mr. Rohatgi, thank you for taking the time out. I have set the entire store by revealing certain details which had not been revealed in the past. And these details cast a big, big question mark over the conduct of the Mumbai police. Mr. Rohatgi, what do you make out of this, sir? Good evening.
Good evening. See, I can elaborate on the legal wrangle which is going on. I am not privy to the kind of evidences which you have discussed in the last 10 minutes that I've seen.
Yes.
But as far as the legal wrangle is concerned, I want to tell you and your viewers in very, very simple terms. After Mr. Rajput died by suicide, apparently, the law requires the local police to conduct what is called an inquest. An inquest is only to determine the cause of death, whether it is natural or unnatural. They have to see whether he died by hanging or did he consume poison or was he murdered. So that is what is called inquest. These are magisterial proceedings. They are supposed to be done in 24 hours. That has nothing to do with an accusation by one against the other. So in the real sense of the term, there is no first information report about any person, against any person, in relation to a crime. As far as the parents are concerned, they lodged an FIR, that is the first information about the death of their son, in the local police station with which they are concerned. They cannot be expected to travel to Bombay to lodge an FIR in Bandra.
True.
So they lodged an FIR with the Bihar police. They put their suspicions and grievances, and they have made serious allegations against Ms. Riya Chakrabarty and her family. Now that FIR has to be investigated according to law by the Bihar police. Pursuant to that investigation, the Bihar police sent a very senior IPS officer. An IPS officer is an officer of the union government who is with the state. So he went there, and mind you, it was shocking to see that a senior IPS officer is locked up perpetually in a quarantine, quote unquote, by an agency of the state government. I mean, I shudder to think what will happen if these kind of things happen between different states. The entire federal polity of this country will crumble. You will have no democracy left. There'll be rule of the jungle. But that apart. Now, with this kind of hullabaloo going on, the whole country watching, the Bihar government did the wisest thing to avoid any charge of being parochial. So the law requires that they can make a request to the Central Bureau of Investigation, which is a body of the union government. It's a police force of the union, not of any state. And in such matters, CBI is asked to step in. So they made a request to show that they are not parochial. And the CBI, I'm glad to say, responded. And they have taken up the investigation. So now they have lodged their own FIR. The Bihar FIR is kind of merged into the FIR of the CBI.
Yes.
They have named a couple of accused, including Riya and her family, and they will investigate. That is the end of it. Neither Bihar nor Mumbai will have anything to do with it at all. And the stand of the Mumbai police that Bihar registered an FIR without jurisdiction is completely wrong. The FIR has to be registered as per an aggrieved person. Now, if the aggrieved person is in Bihar, he will register it in Bihar. He can't go to Bombay to register it. Therefore, this controversy must be put to rest. The CBI will investigate. The CBI has commenced. After FIR, the next step is investigation. They will commence investigation. They must have commenced today or tomorrow. And I think the Supreme Court on the next date of hearing will put a quietus on this legal wrangle and save this country from this intrastate dispute, which is very, very unsavory. And I must say, the Mumbai police, supposedly known for its professionalism, acted in a very undignified and an unprofessional manner. So let this come to an end. The truth will come out through the hands of an impartial agency. And I'm sure and I hope the Supreme Court puts a quietus on this in the next week. That is the sum and substance of all this.
Well, that also looks like perhaps the best option here, that this matter goes through an independent agency for review. Thank you, Mr. Rohatgi.